to introduce Jerry Hu and Godwin Friesen. Jerry is an 18-year-old student who just graduated from Walter Murray Collegiate Institute here in Saskatoon. I happened to be at his graduation ceremony because our son also graduated in that class from the same high school and counts Jerry as a good friend. Jerry has an incredible list of awards and accolades that you can review in the program. This fall, he will be attending the Glenn Gould School of Music in Toronto on a full scholarship. To attend his debut performance as a soloist with the Saskatoon Symphony Orchestra when he was only 16 years old, and it was an incredible concert. Godwin Friesen is an outstanding pianist, composer, and musical collaborator who has received numerous local, national, and international awards and recognition. You can also read about his many awards in the program and his many accomplishments. Godwin graduated from the Glenn Gould School of Music just recently and is now pursuing his graduate studies in music in Montreal. Godwin will be returning to Saskatoon to perform with our symphony next year. Godwin's part of an incredibly musically gifted family, and our family has been very fortunate to attend several concerts put on by his family over the years. Both Jerry and Godwin will briefly say a few words, but before that, I wanted to note a correction in the program. So my dad, Jake, who was one of the organizers of this event, knew that Godwin composed music and had asked Godwin if he would perform one of his own pieces tonight. Godwin replied that he would be happy to perform his composition entitled Prelude and Fugue in A Major, inspired by J.S. Bach, but you'll see in the program it says that it's by J.S. Bach, but in fact what you will be hearing is an original composition by Godwin, inspired by J.S. Bach. So I'll hand this over to Jerry and Godwin.
Very special for me because I'm playing with one of my biggest role models, Godwin Friesen. It's been an absolute blast rehearsing with him these last three days. We've probably done 12 hours total of rehearsal in 3 days, but we're very excited to share this concerto with you later this evening.
And it's been just equally a pleasure for me to play with Jerry, who has been as much an inspiration to me. And just such a special thing for me to be here tonight. Yesterday, when this hall was equally filled, I was repeatedly surprised to see faces from different chapters of my family's past, from living at Shekinah Retreat Center, going to church in Waldheim, going to school in Waldheim, to church in Rostern and Hepburn, and then moving to Saskatoon, where we were also part of Mennonite Church. And so there's so many connections, and there may be some of you who I absolutely recognize, and I just forget which connection it is. So please tell me what that is. My family would have loved to be here, but they live in Eastern Canada now, and so I'm the representative of the Friesens tonight. I want to thank our dear, dear piano teacher, Bonnie Nicholson, who really formed us in my time in Saskatoon and has been for Jerry up until now. She's also been my host, she and her husband Stephen, for these last 3 days, and it has been lovely to be at home in Saskatoon again. So thank you, Bonnie. And now I will play this prelude and fugue, which I composed the fugue last summer, and it was waiting for a prelude, because as many of you would know, Bach famously wrote 48 preludes and fugues, which are some of the great works of the piano repertoire, and now I get to give my own. It's inspired by him, but it's a very different sound, so enjoy this prelude and fugue.
Thank you. And now, the test. The Mennonite Piano Concerto was commissioned from composer Victor Davies in 1975 by the B.B. Fast Foundation with the assistance of Winnipeg musician and scholar Benjamin Horth. Horth wanted the concerto to be based on traditional Mennonite hymns or canonlieder, and so the Mennonite Historic Society compiled a list of 50 hymns for him to choose from, 25 from the General Conference Mennonite Church and 25 from the Mennonite Brethren Church. Davies' challenge, in his own words, was, and I quote, to plan how this vocal music of collective utterance, songs of communal worship, could be transformed into a concerto form, that is, a dramatic dialogue between the individual and the group, and one that involves conflict. This dramatic construction is fundamentally different from the emotional unanimity generated by hymn singing, end quote. And that is a significant challenge. The Mennonite Piano Concerto consists of three separate and contrasting movements. The first movement, in sonata form, begins with the orchestral low strings playing, Jerry, you passed the test. A dialogue between the piano and orchestra follows, and Victor Davies writes, and again I quote, beginning with the joyous content of the two themes, that would be O Jesu, wie viel Gutes and Welchen Jubel, welche Freude, and they are played joyously. Beginning with the joyous content of the two themes, the dramatic path I took, that is Victor Davies, was that of an individual believer who falls into doubt. The appearance of doubt, the ensuing struggles, and subsequent affirmation of belief become the framework for the musical development of the first movement. The second movement, as I mentioned previously, is a set of variations on the theme, on the melody, Verlos und Verlassen. The theme is explored in many musical directions, including a wonderful blues variation. As the variations develop, they increase in complexity, but at the end of the movement, the theme returns in all its beauty and simplicity. The third movement, a rondo, alternates between a recurring main theme and a series of contrasting themes. And again, Davies writes, quote, I chose Wie süß tönt Zaber Glockenklang as the main theme, not knowing that this hymn was usually sung quite slowly. Played at a brisk tempo, the tune suggested to me a cheerful, simple aspect, and indeed, the sound of bells. Now, you will remember how the choir sang Wie süß in the first half. Sedately, like we would in church. We would never get raucous in church, surely. Well, Davies, as he says himself, takes it at quite a clip. The choir cannot sing the words that quickly, but we'll try it on syllable. Victor Davies writes, it also suggested a fun-loving individual. That's editorial. It also suggested a fun-loving individual determined to carry on and be heard in the face of other, more staid themes that would interrupt it. And, as you will find out, they are truly interruptions, as the choir will demonstrate again. Concluded with a final flash of the Zustin Zabek. Doreen Clausen, in an article about Ben Horch, who had the vision for the Mennonite Piano Concerto and who worked closely with the composer Victor Davies, Doreen writes about Ben Horch, and I quote, Horch's impact came from his view that all music is a gift from God, that any musical idiom can speak God's truth, that the most powerful texts may be non-verbal, that minority groups can gain musical acceptance within a dominant society, and finally, that whatever is true, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, think about such things, or whistle them with a twinkle in your eye. Enjoy Mennonite Piano Concerto. Welcome, Jerry and Godwin.
Thank you.